Warning! This video contains skulls, voodoo, fire, lobotomies, and moments of unexpected silliness. Proceed at your own risk. Hi! I'm Kat. And I'm gonna show you how to make this trippy, flippy, whippy-dippy voodoo skull candle. Using just a few simple techniques, you'll have a piece that you can use to curse neighbors and coworkers. Now let's talk inspiration. I drew mine from voodoo witch doctors that you've seen in spy films, children's movies, at the Halloween store, and in 80s hair bands. Now you can sculpt with just about anything. Sporks, clothing hangers. I use sculpting tools. Imagine that. I've also chosen to use air dry clay for this project, bright white. It comes wrapped in a bag and it's moist and ready to go. Yeah, I said moist. And without the requirement of a kiln or baking, this is really easy to use. Just cut a piece the size that you need to do your project. I'm going to be using this little guy as my reference. Isn't he cute? Okay, enough chit-chat. Let's get to sculpting. Now that the sculpt is complete, remember this is going to be a candle. We have to create a place to pour the wax into, so we're going to have to auger this little guy's noggin out. It's lobotomy time. I hope you brought your appetite.
Ah, dessert. Chilled a monkey brain.
After all the clay removal and digging, what we're trying to achieve is a recess about the size of a standard tea light. This is where we're going to be able to pour our melted soy wax to create our candle. Right in there. Right in there. Oop. Once we finally get this piece nice and cleaned up, polished, all the ridges removed, smoothed out, we're going to move on to our next step. What's a voodoo witch doctor without a wicked top hat? I ended up doing some searching online to find a style that I really liked. I landed on this one with this really cool upturned brim. Now we start sculpting the hat, brim up, using our actual skull that we've sculpted as a size reference. Try saying size of a sculpted skull three times fast. Size of a sculpted skull, size of a sculpted skull, so oh yeah, okay. Let's just do this. The right shape and size, it's time to start building upward the vertical of the top of the hat. It's much like building a coil pinch pot. You just keep working until the hat is the height you desire. As an extra detail, I decided to put a notch in the front of my top hat. For a little added extra sass. Then we move on to adhering the top of the top hat. Remember to use slip and to score your edges before you start blending. Then go ahead and use your clay tools to smooth everything out. There's a lot of bumps and ridges, so just keep working on it until you get the look that you desire. With the sculpting portion of this project complete, you're gonna wait about 2 weeks for your clay to dry. This means you're gonna have to find ways to amuse yourself. I used the time to select a psychedelic pattern that I could draw into my hat before painting. We're going to use acrylic paint for this project. Just like the clay, it's water-based, and it's super easy to find in art and craft supply stores. minor detailing and dots that you're going to see on this project, I elected to use an acrylic paint marker. And as the final step in the painting process, we're going to finish up the weathering of the skull. And we're going to work our way into all of those cracks and crevices. We're going to get in his nostril, right in those eyeballs. We're going to use gloss medium. That's what's making this a little bit shiny. And we're going to make sure we really make his complexion look amazing. Like, contouring. It is so important. You must contour. Am I right, ladies? Once the top hat has had time to dry, it's time to accessorize! I just went online and picked up some little inexpensive plastic skulls and bones, and I'm just adhering them to the hat using super glue. Now let's start thinking about what voodoo smells like. I used just a few simple materials to start mixing my essential oil scents. And the way that I imagine voodoo smelling falls somewhere in the realm of patchouli oil, dirt, eye of newt. You get the idea. Finally, we get to melt the wax and make that candle. First, you're gonna need some supplies though. Trivet, it's gonna get pretty hot. Soy wax flakes, a little pot with a thermometer, your essential oil, a wooden spoon, your pot for making a double boiler, and don't forget those oven mitts. It's gonna get hot in here! Scoop 8 cups of soy wax flakes into your melting pot. Prepare your skull with a wick. Use a wick bar to keep it in place. Now let us journey to the kitchen to go melt our wax. Using the pre-discussed double boiler, we're going to be melting our wax and adding any colorants until we reach a temperature of 185 degrees. Now that our desired temperature has been reached, we're going to add our essential oils. And we're going to continue stirring until we reach a temperature of 135 degrees. That's when you can pour. This takes a while. Knock knock. Who's there? Voodoo. Voodoo who?
Voodoo you think you are, asking me so many questions. Hey, your wax is 135 degrees now.
It's time to pour! And I made a holy mess.
1 week later.
The wax will have cured. You can cut the wick and get lit. Always make sure you put out the candle before you put the top hat on for display. If you enjoy casting voodoo spells and this video, go ahead and hit subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and ring that bell to see what I get up to next. Thanks so much for watching, Cat Liebens Art.